Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. Now the problem that you see on your screen right now is taken from the second practice test contained in the new SAT official SAT study guide, okay? Just released by College Board, the blue book for the new SAT exam. The new SAT, as you know, will start in March of 2016. Okay, so practice test 2 in the official guide, section 3, no calculator. Practice question number 15. So it gives you an expression, which is a fraction, and it asks you to find the equivalent form, right? So something that you can either simplify or you can split, right? So first of all, you see here that there are two terms in the numerator, and as you know, we can't split the denominator because it's just one number. We have to keep it, right? Based on the properties of algebra, we can split the numerator, but we cannot split the denominator because we will divide by the denominator, right? So we can split the numerator into 5x, and then the second term will be minus 2, right? So we're going to add negative 2 to 5x. So two of these terms are added in the numerator, and both of them are divided by x plus 3. So we can split it, and as you know, the reason why I bring up splitting is because, as you see in the answer choices, you have things splitting, right? You have, well, at least for three choices, you can see things split here, right? You can see 5 by itself in all of these three choices. So there must be something done to the numerator and the denominator, right? So at least we know that we can split 5x, and then we can split minus 2, right, from each other. So let's see if we use the long division, right? And you've probably used long division for regular numbers, whole numbers in the past. So performing long divisions with polynomials is very similar, right? So we take the 5x minus 2, which is the numerator, and we put it inside the bracket, which is the place for the dividend, right? So the dividend, which is the numerator, is 5x minus 2, and it's inside the bracket. And then the divisor, right, we're going to divide the dividend by x plus 3, right? So divisor divides 5x minus 2. So the divisor is x plus 3, and that is equivalent to the denominator of the fraction. So x plus 3 is the divisor, and it's put outside, right across, right, horizontally from the dividend. And then whatever is on the top will be your quotient. And as you know, the remainder is whatever is left off, and we can't do it, we can't go any further, so we leave the demand, the remainder, and the remainder will be divided by the divisor still, right? So in other words, you'll have some kind of fraction left. You'll have a whole number by itself, which will be without a fraction, of course, because it's a whole number, and you will also have the second term as a fraction. And that's really close to what you see in the answer choices, right? So let's see how this works. So if we divide, let's see how we can divide this. So we take 5x minus 2, we're going to divide it by x plus 3. So the way to go is you take the 5x, right? You first take the first term, you divide it over by x, and you get 5. Because there are 5x's in 5x, in the product which is made by 5 times x. So there are 5 such x's. So after you get this whole number 5, you must multiply it back with the divisor to, and whatever you get, you put it underneath the dividend. Just like in the regular numbers, the long division with the regular numbers that you've performed before. Right? So you take whatever you get with the multiplication, you multiply it back, you put it underneath the dividend, and then you subtract. So we have, when we return the multiplication, we get 5 times x, and we distribute, and then we get plus 5 times 3, right, which is 15. So we get 5 times x plus 15. Right? And remember, we gotta write it exactly vertically together, these numbers, so that we can easily subtract them, the like terms, right? Because 5 times x, whatever is in front of x must be vertically aligned well, and whatever is the constant without the x, right, must be also vertically aligned properly, right? So So remember that we're going to subtract, and when we subtract, we're going to get 5x minus 5x, which is 0. That's why we don't have anything here. And then minus 2 we'll subtract as well. We'll have minus 15, right? So we're going to subtract 15 from negative 2. So minus 2 minus 15 will be negative 17, right? So as you see here, we can't divide any further. We will be unsuccessful because 17 doesn't have any x to it, right? We can't do anything with negative 17 and x plus 3 as a denominator. So we have to leave this remainder divided by the divisor. So that will be a fraction that remains. And this fraction will be added to the quotient, which is the whole number 5. Just like with regular numbers, right? So we will have two parts to the answer. 5, the quotient by itself, and then we're going to add the fraction, which will be comprised of negative 17 in the numerator and x plus 3 in the denominator, right? So we will have the answer 5 minus, right, because minus 17, so it has to be a minus, minus 17 divided by x plus 3. So choice D is the correct answer. Now, if you feel like you can't do this, if you feel like the long division is really hard for you to understand, especially with polynomials, remember, let's go through this one more time, just the beginning steps. When you see, usually, I'll tell you this, the trick is the following. You put the numerator as a dividend here inside the bracket, and you put the divisor, the denominator, in the divisor place here. And remember that the dividend, when it's a proper fraction, right? A proper means that you're able to divide, right? It's greater than one, at least one and greater, right? So we judge by the powers of x. So the power of x in the dividend must be at least the same and higher as the power of x, the leading power of x for the divisor. So 5x, x is to the first power in the dividend, and x is to the first power in the divisor. So in other words, if this was to the first power in the dividend and the divisor would be a second power, we would be unsuccessful in dividing, right? So the dividend power of the x in the variable must be at least the same in number, in its magnitude, as the power of x in the divisor. Right, so in this case, if you have the same powers of x, it's possible to divide, which is why we were successful. Right, so in other words, this could have been x, x squared, x to the third. It just cannot be x to the zero power, because x to the zero power is just going to be 5. Right, and 5, we would not have been successful dividing 5 by x plus 3. Right, we would not have been able to simplify it any further. Right, it would just be x. 5 would just be a remainder. It would look like a remainder, right? So we have to have the same powers of x, or greater for the dividend relative to the divisor. Okay. So this is the trick that you must follow. And remember, you first compare the two variables with the powers. So you take the leading power of the dividend and you relate it to the leading power of the divisor. So you divide them both. You divide the dividend expression that involves the highest power in the x in the variable, and you divide that over by the greatest power variable in the divisor, and you get 5 as a result. And remember, after that you will multiply 5 with the to the divisor, and then you will, whatever you get, you write it underneath the original dividend, and then you subtract. Okay, you subtract and you get whatever you get after that. And remember, we would have more steps if we had a square in the for the power of x in the dividend. We would have to have one more step like this here to arrive at the constant without any x attached to it. Make sense? Okay, so just before you leave, I'd like you to take a look at the second method that actually the College Board suggested in their study guide. So basically, this is a way to avoid the long division. involving the polynomials. And the way to do that is to understand that you can actually transform the original numerator, 5x minus 2, into this equivalent form. Right? So we didn't touch the denominator, it was just x plus 3. We touched the numerator. And why did we transform it this way? Because you see x plus 3, since it multiplies 5, it can actually cancel out with the x plus 3 in the denominator, and we would get 5. And how do we do that? So if you want to make sure that you can cancel it out, if you want to create x plus 3 here, remember you have to have something afterwards so that negative 2 is still there. So when you have x plus 3, you will have 5x plus 15. So 15 is the number. So what happens to 15? What do you do to 15 to get it back to negative 2? Well, logic suggests that in order for 15 to turn to negative 2, you have to subtract 17 from it. Right? So you subtract 17 from 15 and you get negative 2, which is why we subtracted 17. And guess what? It's exactly what we did here. That's the same answer. Because x plus 3 is canceled out, and we will get 5 minus, remember the minus is still there, 17 divided by x plus 3. And that's exactly the same answer that we arrived at using the long division with the polynomials. Right? So choice D is the correct answer. Thank you for watching this video. Please visit my website, revisethisat.com. I'm a mathematician, as you can probably tell. And I've designed my own prep system for sections 3 and 4. Right, math sections of the new SAT exam. There are lots of questions, over 800 problems in the system. You can start practicing for free right now. You can start practicing for free as we speak. There's a trial period. You don't have to pay anything to start practicing. There are timed exams in the system, and there are lots of practice questions as well. By timed exams, I mean there are 80 minutes allotted for sections 3 and 4, so you will not get away with anything. You will have to really complete it in 80 minutes, so it's a good practice. So visit the website revisethisat.com, watch the video in great detail that tells you what the practice system will look like. You will have your own user account with login information, username and password. Watch the video. It will show you how your account will look like. You will see what your pages will look like, what your questions will look like. Okay, and there are complete solutions as well to all practice tests and practice questions. And remember that I'm adding more and more questions along the way. You will get to enjoy them for the rest of your life. So the practice test is still 4 months away. You will have plenty of time to practice more and more. Okay, and you will not have to pay anything other than what you will have already paid. All right, so right now, join for free. You don't have to pay for anything. Start practicing right now as we speak. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you for staying so long, and I'll see you in my next video. Please come back soon. Take care.